Your favorite internet best friends just became your best friend. I'm Brianna Fox.
And I'm Amanda Devon. We've teamed up to create a space where we can get comfortable with being vulnerable to talk candidly about life in our 30s.
Get ready to laugh, cry, and guide each other off the ledge we call life.
This is In Her Skin.
I'm like, starting cold. I've been keeping my house at, guess what I've been keeping it at? Except for just now, I turned it to 68 because I got hot, but...
So 70 though?
72.
I know. Who are that you? Comfortable.
Part of it too is I'm wearing like tank tops and shorts. Like I'm like dressed.
Like you coming to my house in sweatpants? knowing that it's going to be 73 in my house? Every time.
I know.
Every time.
Okay, are you ready, Spaghetti?
I am.
Okay, today's going to be a very fun episode. I'm really excited about it. We are going to be, responding to your embarrassing stories. And we have a plethora. I don't know if we're going to get through all of them because there's a lot.
I love that for us.
So, are you ready to just get after
Let's
it?
Let's just dive right in.
All right.
Do you want to go first or do you want me to go first?
Oh, yeah, you have one. Yeah. You start.
Let me start with this one. And we're going to keep everything anonymous, of course, as always. Love that you guys are participating, and especially now that...
Okay. I had to adjust my tits. Perfect. I was like, while you're looking.
I love that you guys are participating, especially that now that you know that you're anonymous, you guys can send us anything. It's safe with us and the internet, just not your name.
Yeah, the one girl who like really went there, I feel like you guys were probably like, oh, okay, I can submit now, because now there's like way more submissions.
I love that. You just need somebody to... You gotta test it out first, okay? So I get it. Okay, so first embarrassing story. So she got invited to a white elephant party, and her gift was a whoopee cushion. But everyone else was wearing like white linen pants and heels and drinking white wine and setting down all these beautiful wrapped non-whoopee cushion gifts. And then the exchange started, and they're going around, and mine's like the fifth one. And the first four are beautiful candle sets, some pewter utensils, crystal candle holders. And I'm just waiting, shitting, watching it become the girl's turn to open mine. And then she did. And she looked and she looked like she was going to cry and acted like someone assaulted her. And all these ladies were comforting her for whoever would just ruin the exchange with such a mean joke. And that she can pick another gift. And so basically... she said that after that she was embarrassed and left the party early.
I'm embarrassed for them. What?
Thank what? You. Okay, I need to understand something. Who? There's clearly two sets of different people who. Why can't I fucking think of the word? There's two different types of people who think what white elephant are.
Yeah, I was thrown off by the candle sets. Excuse me?
The white elephant that I grew up with is just like ridiculous. It could be raunchy. It could be ridiculous. It could be just be like stupid, funny, whatever that it is. But it's not a nice gift.
No, it's anything but. It's a shake weight. It's Vagisil. It's a condom. But like
used.
Tiny.
Used. Not even, yeah. Not even brand new, like used.
Yes. So I'm embarrassed for them.
I know.
And then on top of it, say you did go to, so I love her approach then too, to realize, oh shit, it's not that kind of party. To then be like, well, this is going to be even better. And then for her to be like offended by the whoopee cushion, fuck you.
Yeah,
I'm out of here. Out. Like, this is weird. Because that would have been even funnier then. The fact that these are all nice gifts and then you open up a whoopee cushion, I would have died laughing.
Oh, man. But I'm like, I'm so glad that you left because you realize those just aren't your people.
Yeah. Yeah. Like, I'm sorry. I'm never coming back here.
If I had to, like, show up and they... again, like, even just, like, the descriptions of what people are, like, wearing at the party. And you're just, like, showing up. And you're like, oh, it's not going to be that kind of party. And like, I don't want to be here for the gifts because already you're like, fuck.
Yeah.
This is a whole different set of people that we're dealing with here.
Yeah, this is fancy and I didn't know. And like, let us know that it's going to be like fancy.
I know.
Let me know. Just let me know. I was on a first date with a really cute guy I had been wanting to go out with for a while. He took me to a really nice restaurant in Chicago and things were going great. I got up to use the restroom, did my thing, and was freshening up in the mirror. Lots of women around talking amongst each other. I went back to my date and we got up to leave. I heard lots of giggles and felt like everyone was looking at me. We got outside and we were walking down the sidewalk, and then my date yelled, "Oh my God," and pointed at my butt. That's when I saw a long ass piece of toilet paper tucked inside the back of my skirt, just blowing in the wind. None of the girls in the bathroom thought to tell me I had a 3-foot long streamer of toilet paper behind me as I walked through a crowded restaurant. Definitely a memorable first date, to say the least. Oh, that's right. It's a first date.
And like, not in the skirt. Like,
at least he said something. Like, that's very, you know, sweet. Like, for him to like, that would be worse if, like, you got home and it was there.
Yeah, and I'm just type of person that, like, if anything is malfunctioning on you, whether it's a piece of clothing, you have toilet paper, you have something in your teeth, I'm like, hey, get that really quick.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know, like, it shouldn't be an embarrassing thing to tell somebody to do that.
Yeah.
And, like, if I was one of a stranger, I would have literally just, like, as you walk by, grabbed it from you and been like, hey.
Yeah.
Took care of it. You're fine.
Can I tell you, I have these bike shorts that I wore out the other day, mm-hmm. and thank God, I had on a long baggy t-shirt with it. And normally, even with a baggy t-shirt, I tuck it up over my butt because I hate when I walk and my butt like pulls the it shirt. Tight. It's like, I'd rather just be like up. Normally, I would do that. But I kept it long and didn't change it once throughout the day, like to go up.
Yeah.
I had my bike shorts on inside out and the tag.
Oh, no. Those are so long. Just flapping in the wind.
And I got home and I was like, what the oh my God, like, and then I had to recount my day and make sure I didn't do that. But
that's hilarious. Yeah.
But yeah, geez, what's with them like not helping you out?
I know. So in aesthetic school, we were learning the waxing portion. Talk about the most dreaded day in school minus the state boards.
She's like, someone waxed my vagina and they weren't supposed to, and it got like stuck. Like the
one I said. Holy
like
shit.
She's submitting the story.
Oh, God. Anyway. after I got the okay to take clients at the school/spa, I had a client who was on her period. I hadn't done a lot of Brazilians yet, so I was pretty inexperienced in them. I went to put wax down in the labia area, and I forgot that the client had a tampon in, and the wax got entangled in the string.
And out came the tampon.
So when I went to pull the wax, the tampon came out with it. The client and I looked awkwardly at each other, and she ended her service early, and I never saw her again. I refused to do another Brazilian after that, but fast forward 4 years out of graduation, waxing is now what I do for a living, so when a client comes in on her period, I have to mentally prepare myself. Oh, that my is God. Hilarious.
I can't believe she ended it early. If that happened to me, I'd be like, oh my God, I'm like, you're talented. Like, you grab my purse, I gotta put another one back in.
I couldn't imagine having my tampon just ripped out.
Like, how can you not die laughing?
Ma'am, and like, okay, I understand, like, periods are you know, inconvenient, but like, I also wouldn't be getting waxed on my period.
That was my first thought.
I wouldn't do that. Why are you there?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah. Or like, so I've gotten spray tanned. Remember when we got spray tanned together and I had my period?
Not in your vagina.
But even still, like, I took the string and I tucked it up.
Shoved it up
there. I was like, like, why wouldn't you do that then? If you, I mean, you're their spread eagle, like, she's getting in your crevices.
Yeah, because I, like, as the waxer, I wouldn't be, like, I'd feel weird, like, trying to maneuver the string. I feel like I'd be sexually assaulting you at that point because I'm, like, trying to, like, just. Like, I can't. I'm not doing that. That is hilarious, though.
Oh, my gosh.
That is definitely a learning experience. Definitely one that you will never forget.
Definitely.
I love that she's, like, now still a waxer, though. She's like, you know what? That's my thing.
And she didn't say, like, oh, please don't come in on your period. No, I'm just like, well, we just remembered this now.
Put a piece of tape on it. Just, like, one of those slivers of tape just covering your vagina.
Double-sided so it sticks to the string. And then you can stick it to where you need.
Perfect.
Okay. Love the podcast before the rebrand, but loving it even more since you guys got together.
Oh, thanks.
Thanks. My most embarrassing moment was my sophomore year of high school. It was 10 minutes into the homecoming dance, and I broke my knee doing the Soulja Boy.
No, like, not the Soulja Boy.
I ended up having to be carried out of the dance and in the ER for five hours and a cast for 14 weeks. I was also sought out by the yearbook committee my senior year to put the story in the yearbook, the most embarrassing high school moments. But, I mean, that makes sense.
Yeah, that's pretty
fast forward to now, my knee has never been right, and I ended up re-injuring the knee and had three surgeries within 4 months. I have never lived it down to this day.
No.
Fuck. Like, it sounds like you're our age. Like
now that, like, so something obviously it happened that sucked, but now you're being haunted for the rest of your life for just doing the Soulja Boy at a school dance.
Damn.
Never letting you live that down.
Damn. That sucks. Knee injuries are no joke.
Yeah, seriously. Like, anything with a joint. Like, I just... And, like, you're on your knees.
Yeah, no. You, like...
There's a lot of positions where your knees are taking the blunt beating. But yeah, wow, that sucks. I'm so sorry for you. First, love y'all energy. Yay, thank you. I'm a mom of two and don't get to spend much time with my girlfriends these days. So listening, watching you guys makes me feel like I'm hanging out with my girlies again.
Oh, yay.
That's what we love. That's what we wanted. Thank you so much. I don't care if you use their names, but not mine, please. I have to keep some dignity. This probably isn't my most embarrassing story, but the first one that popped in my head. When I was in sixth grade, I had the biggest crush on my teacher, like hardcore. And I even threw an I love you party at my, it's his name. I'm not going to put his name, but I love you blank party at my house. And we made t-shirts, but that's not the most embarrassing part. I was extremely painfully shy growing up, super quiet, never volunteered to read, never raised my hand and asked questions, never got to throw something away. Like, I wanted zero attention on me at all times. So I was in his class right after lunch and someone, never me, that she said, got us all in trouble. So we had to be quiet the entire, oh, she said never me, that she didn't get anybody in trouble.
No, she's like always good.
Always the good girl. Got us in trouble, so we had to be quiet the entire class and read silently. My stomach starts rumbling. I'm looking at the clock. There's still half the class left. I tell myself that I can wait until in between classes, and then I'll go to the bathroom. My stomach starts hurting more, and I need to fart. I start opening my agenda book to fill out a hall pass to use the bathroom. Mind you, I never asked to use the bathroom in class. Walk up in front of the class, speak to the teacher, I would never. But that's how severe the situation was. I'm clenching my booty hole harder than I ever have in my life. I'm sweating. I'm filling out this hall pass, and before I know it, the biggest, loudest fart escapes my butt cheeks, and in this dead-ass silent room full of my peers and my potential future husband, the teacher. In my head, I'm like, maybe no one will know it was me. My dreams were quickly shattered when this bitch, names yes. her, sitting in front of me, whips her head and goes, why did you do that? And she was like, I had the choice. I chose to bust out in front of all these people, including my current love of my life. Everyone starts laughing, including the teacher. I build two stacks of my books on my desk, and I put my head in between them for the rest of the class.
Oh, no.
Sulk and suffering until the bell rings. I couldn't even get out of that class fast enough, but the teacher asked me to come to his desk after the bell rang. As if I wasn't embarrassed enough, he smiled at me and said, next time, why don't you just ask to use the bathroom? I'm melting. I'm in a puddle of disgust. By the next class, word had already traveled around the whole school, and I was the class farter. My life would never be the same. My future altered over this one, not just over this little fart. The fart heard around the world. I somehow managed to survive the rest of the school day. When my mom picked me up from school, I got in her car and I told her everything that happened in super dramatic detail. And the most important fact was that the teacher witnessed this horrific accident and he'll never love me.
Because of the fart.
Because of the fart. But because I could even finish, she started hysterically laughing, like crying laughing. I think she had to pull over and calm down or she would have wrecked us. I should mention that she thinks farting is one of the funniest things ever, so she couldn't contain herself, even in my moment of self-loathing and pity. And she knew my obsession with the teacher. So it made me laugh, though she was laughing so hard. She told me not to worry about it. Someone will fart in class tomorrow and forget all about me doing it, which was true until parent-teacher conferences. My mom came with me, and we saved my teacher for last. He sees us and has us both come in the classroom. He says to my mom, you see that poster there on the cabinet door? It was directly behind where I sat in class. I had to put a poster over the whole her fart blew in my cabinet earlier this year. My mom died laughing again, and he talked about nothing but the fart. I think he may have said I was passing the class as well as I passed gas or something. To keep it weird, the teacher and I celebrated the day I farted for years after that. He wrote me a poem about it. He went on to be my high school basketball coach and continued to joke about the fart every chance he could. Needless to say, me and the teacher didn't get married, but he taught me a valuable lesson. Laugh at life and just go to the freaking bathroom if you need to.
That was cute.
Oh. Especially when you're young and you have a crush on a teacher, like everything is like morbid. It's like, no, why would I do that?
Which I have to say, like, I have such an issue, like, now that I'm an adult thinking about like the bathroom situation in school, it is just wild. Like, you literally only have 2 minutes to go to the bathroom in between classes and get your books and get to your class. There's just no time.
No.
If you have diarrhea, even just if you have to fart, if you have your period, whatever, like, you can't, there's no time,
right?
And accidents are bound to happen.
And if she didn't have to spend 20 minutes filling out a damn hall pass,
exactly,
she could have just left the room to go to the bathroom, none of that would have happened.
That's like, I get it, like, kids really can't be trusted, but like,
and like the safety of them, like, I get it, but there's got to be something to,
like,
change.
Like, you have 3 emergency passes that you can just set down or something. I don't know. Yeah. There needs to be something, but I love the fart joke.
So funny. I know. Like, had to put a poster to cover the hole.
Yes.
Hilarious.
I'm a Chicago native, so I'm sure you'll know where most of these places are. Let's jump right into one of the most disgusting and embarrassing things that's happened to me. It started on a musty, humid summer day in 2009 after graduating college. I was checking out places in Edgewater, ready to get my first big girl apartment. After scoping out the neighborhood, I thought it would be a good idea to try out some of the local West African food. I ate curry goat, greens, and some other meat I didn't dare ask what it was. I lived in Bridgeport at the time, so I decided to stop and do some shopping in the Loop before getting home. I'm going to be honest, I don't know where any of these places are. I'm like so unfamiliar with the neighborhoods.
I know where they are.
You do.
Yeah.
I hopped on the train and everything was totally fine. First stop was Macy's and I'm pursuing the sunglasses when the sensation hits. I started to sweat and get warm. Oh no, that food was not sitting right. I panicked to try and find a bathroom, but sadly, I didn't make it. Did I mention I was wearing what? Of course you're wearing white linen pants.
No.
The only private spot I quickly found was a women's dressing room, so I did what I had to do in there, but my white linen pants had been stained, and of course, I just spent most of my money on my new apartment's deposit, so I couldn't afford new pants. Being a broke college kid, I made my way back to the Green Line, avoiding eye contact, fearing everyone would know what I did. Just my luck, when the train pulls up, it's jam-packed with Sox fans. So, of course, there's a game today, and I lived three blocks from Comiskey. I managed to secure a seat so no one would have to be assaulted by my poop pants. But once we arrived to the 35th stop, I did my best to hustle through the crowd. I thought I was home free when some drunk bro goes, "Hey, I think you sat in some shit on the train."
That's like the perfect, like, scenario.
Yeah, because he, that
worst
he,
case here.
He probably actually thought you did sit in something. Yeah,
correct. Yeah. And I would have blamed it on that too. Like, oh no. No.
I probably turned several shades of red and ran home the rest of the way. Oh my gosh. That sucks.
That does. That's like my, every time I wear white, I'm like, anything can happen. I can sit in shit. I could shit, bleed, anything. It's a risk that you have to take. I was in the 6th grade at the time, and I was wearing my new cute Old Navy white shorts, a white t-shirt, and some white sandals.
Why can't we just, like, shit our pants and get our periods in black pants?
I know, right? Gosh. I don't know where this is going to go, but I love the all-white outfit. You're very dedicated and very scary at the same time. So after athletics, I started cramping. I asked my teacher to go to the bathroom, and he said no. Okay, another thing that we just brought up. Fucking weird.
Your Let me go to asshole. The bathroom.
Everything was okay. Well, the next day, I wore the same shorts, but a neon green t-shirt and some black Converse. At lunchtime, I sat down to open my lunch and realized I forgot to pack myself a drink. As I got up to go buy a Diet Dr. Pepper from the vending machine, I felt a huge gush. Blood poured down my leg and got all over the seat. Needless to say, I got sent home, and my crush at the time saw everything. I died that day. Oh, I feel so bad. But, like, what a universal experience. Like, I have bled through my pants onto the seat. Thankfully, in the comfort of my own home or around people that I love and that love me and know my situation, I've never had to do – I've maybe I have. I can't remember if that's ever happened to me at school, but.
Oh, that happened, like, to me at school in seventh grade.
Yes,
I asked to go to the bathroom, didn't let me. And it was like one of those, like, you know, like the science room stools where it's like bamboo or something. Mm-hmm. They probably had to throw that out because you can't clean that up.
Right.
But, and then at least they sent you home. I had to go to, they made me put gym shorts over my jeans.
Yeah. Like, and now I'm going to sit in blood.
Thanks, dry guys. Blood. Pisses me off.
But yeah, that's so sad and embarrassing. And like at that age too, when you're in sixth grade, like right before you become a teenager, you're just so, ugh.
Everything's just like extra embarrassing at that time. At the time, I had just turned 20. I was going, I can't read today.
It's okay.
At the time, I just turned 20. I was going to go out with my best friend and a few guys at a restaurant to maybe get to know a guy that I liked. We got there, ordered our drinks and food. Well, I started drinking my Diet Dr. Pepper and I felt these bubbles in my stomach. I'm nervous. I'm a nervous farter, by the way.
Oh, no. Wait, I can't. A nervous farter. And like, especially drinking like anything caffeinated. Oh, over.
Oh, yeah.
Tooting all night.
Oh, she's like, my stupid ass thought it would be silent. Oh, no. Why would you trust that? No. Why would you trust that? Knowing you're a nervous farter. No, it was not silent. I kind of wiggled my butt around as I farted. Even worse. Why would you wiggle it around? No, like, and then it's like. And it sounded so loud and smelled like sewage and rotten eggs. No. Needless to say, the guy didn't talk to me after that.
Like those silent but deadly ones.
Well, at least if it's silent and it is deadly, you'd be like, oh, I would call. Oh, did you smell that?
Wait, can you imagine? Do you know? Do you remember the scene? And or have you watched the movie Ted? First of all, Ted with the
yeah.
Okay, and do you remember the scene where they're like out to dinner and he farts?
Yes.
He's like, I just farted. And he's like, let's see who gets to first. He turns around. It's like a group of businessmen. They're like, who did this to us? We're on business. Yeah. It's one of my favorite scenes of all time.
It's so good.
I love that. Aww.
You know what? Speaking of nervous things, when I get nervous, I get cold. I get the shivers. Mm-hmm. I think that's probably common, actually.
I think so, too. It's your body's natural reaction. This is another poop story. The second one says, I used to have a fuck buddy that used to love anal, so we're going to go there. So, okay. Okay. There's a two-part series to this. Okay. Sadly, these are both poop stories. So the first one, on my 21st birthday, my boyfriend at the time and I got wasted off of Belvedere at my house. As the night was winding down, I changed into lingerie and that I had bought for a special night of birthday sex. Unfortunately, he denied me, saying I was too wasted and was going to end up puking. I threw a big fit about it, and then, alas, he was correct. I was throwing up in the toilet in my nightie while suddenly both ends start spewing. I tried cleaning things up, but he came in the bathroom at some point and asked if I had shit my pants. I tried denying it, but it was pretty obvious. I tried denying it, and it was pretty obvious, but I ended up showering and passed out. Luckily, he never said too much about it afterwards, but I was humiliated. Second one. I used to have a friends with benefit that loved to do anal. I'm not a fan, but would give in occasionally. Well, one time we went to a wedding together and had a hotel room for afterwards. I had agreed to giving him some butt sex that night, but was so drunk. We did it, and I didn't recall the details of how we stopped. Did we stop because we were done or something else? I don't know. Well, I went to the bathroom after, and there was poop all over me. And I was like, what the fuck is happening? And he's like, yeah, you got poop all over me. So embarrassing, but I told him that's the risk you take for going for that hole. Our fuck buddy status ended after that night.
A lot of shit stories. I teach secondary school in the UK, equivalent to high school in the United States. I was teaching a year 11 class and helping a boy with his work, and my shirt popped open, exposing my bra. To this day, I have never worn a button shirt to work.
Especially like in a high school like situation that's...
Yeah.
And like being a teacher around students and you're having a wardrobe malfunction, like absolutely not.
Yeah.
Anything like that has to do with high school or just being in school with students, whether you're the student and you have an embarrassing moment or a teacher.
Yeah.
It's just an embarrassing place to be, which is stupid because it shouldn't be embarrassing, but it is.
When we were in freshman year of high school, I went to a Christian private high school and we had like a sex ed class. Mm-hmm. And in the class, and I wasn't even in this class, so this tells you like it got talked about. But the teacher at the end of the class, she was like, if you have any questions, ask them now. It was like the first day of school. She was like, after this, you won't be allowed to ask like any, like, just like, nothing's off the table. Ask me anything. And like, I guess one of the kids said, if you don't use it, do you lose it?
That's fucking hilarious. So I'd like to put partial blame on my story to two things. One, my overactive bowels, and two, Chick-fil-A.
Perfect. So many poop stories. Oh my gosh.
So if you have weak stomachs, please stop reading. So clearly my story starts with a spicy chicken deluxe from Chick-fil-A. That's my fucking favorite.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Good choice.
Good choice. I was then enjoying my day off going shopping at an outlet mall nearby when the feeling hit me. You know, the, okay, there's not much time, but I hate going poop in public because of the noise. Luckily, I was only about 6 or 7 minutes away from my home. So I decided to go home early, and on my way home, the feeling stopped for a bit. So I even thought about turning back around, but I'm so glad I didn't and went home to do my business. Sadly, I didn't make it. The feeling came back and it came back quick. The only thing I had in my car was a pick and save grocery bag, not like a plastic bag, a reusable one. As quickly as I could, I put the bag under my butt while driving to protect my car seat. You guys, it was so bad. I don't need to explain. So anyway, I made it home and sadly, my neighbor's kids were outside and they wanted to talk. So basically, I talked to them while awkwardly walking inside backwards to my home. Meanwhile, said accident was rolling down my leg. I can't believe I'm sharing this. So I have dogs. I let them outside. My entrance is where the backyard is, and I ran straight to the shower. Sadly, this isn't the end. One dog decided to roll in my poo, and the other decided to lick it up. It smelled so bad, and then I had to give them both baths. I mean, thank goodness no one was home, and the kids across the street didn't hang around long, but girl, it was embarrassing for myself. That is
why the dog
fucking gross. Just to even piggyback off that, Hunter was in, my nephew, was in a little, like, I don't know, play thing, and he's standing and he had a blowout and it was running down his leg and her dog went and licked it up. And she was like, no! She's like, God! It was just like hectic, whatever.
Yeah.
So clearly that's a dog thing. Don't know why. That's fucking gross. Like,
why do you have to
but
lick
that is
poop?
Hilarious. Just like one's rolling in the shit while the other one's just eating it up. Like, why?
Like, stop it. Why do you need
and, like,
to lick
it?
And
like, you're already like stressed that you just shit yourself.
You're vulnerable.
It's running down your leg. You have to run to the shower. You have to. And then you're like, you look at the two. Just two dogs that let you down.
Too much. Ugh. Have you ever shat your pants?
Oh, multiple times.
Okay, yeah, same.
Never where it's ran down. I've just sharted a lot.
Yeah, it's always like a, oh.
Yeah, it's always like I thought I farted and then I shit. But I think that there's only one time where it actually like released from my cheeks and like got onto my jeans.
Okay.
A lot of times it's just like I'll do it and it's like a quick
it's
squirt
like stuck
and I'm
in
like
your
oh,
ass.
Gotta go and then I run to the bathroom.
The funniest time that happened to me was when I was working at Sephora and I had to call in work because I was sitting at the table with my mom and I had on like shorts. They were short shorts and I never wear underwear. And I'm sitting there just like hanging out with her and I didn't even fart. It just escaped my body. Like yeah. I didn't even there was no warning. And I was like, I looked at my mom. I was like, I think I shit my pants. She's like, yeah. And I stand up and I'm like, oh my God. And I hear her go, oh yeah, it's on the seat.
No.
And I called into work and I was like, I can't come to work. I just shit my pants. Cause then it like, I was like, I feel like it's going to keep coming.
Yeah.
And,
yeah, at that point you clearly must be ill.
Something's wrong. It's never happened before. Yeah. And the best part is that everyone gave the phone to everyone at work. It must have been a slow day. Cause then like Judy got on and she's like, here's what you gotta do. You gotta blah, blah. Like, I love that everyone's giving me advice. But
hilarious.
Love
yeah, the
shit
time
story.
That I like actually like shit, like full on shit my pants. I had a family dinner. It was just me, my mom, my dad, my sister. We went to Hamada. And if anybody knows what Hamada is, it's just like Asian cuisine, hibachi, if you will. Delicious. And we're on our way back. And I'm like, ooh, I feel like my stomach rumbling, whatever. We get home, goes away. I'm like actively getting ready to leave the house because now that we're back from dinner, I have plans and I'm going to go out. In the midst of me like getting my things, I get a little rumble in my tummy. I go to fart, completely shit my pants, like just completely shit. And I literally, I'll never forget, I was upstairs. My parents are in the living room and I go, no! And they're like, what's wrong? And I was like, I just shit my pants, like screaming. And my parents are downstairs cracking up. I get into the shower and take my pants off because I fucking diarrhea in my pants.
Yeah.
And I was like, I can't believe I did that. I think I was like 20, 21. I think it was 20 when that happened. So
that's so funny.
But yeah, and I've just shit myself more than that, but that was like the worst time. Not embarrassing, just like inconvenient. I'm like, yeah. Why the fuck do I have to clean this up now?
Ruben always makes fun of me because I always shit my pants, and he just like never pants. Had until, he's going to kill me. He shit Love his it. Pants within the last year.
Ooh.
And I was like, welcome to the club.
Like, I've been here.
I'm like, welcome. It's nice. Stay a while.
Fuck. I've also been like so sick from the flu where I was actively throwing up and shitting at the same time. So I had to get in the bathtub because I couldn't contain both yes, ends. So like I was throwing up and shitting in the tub at the same time.
I've had that before and my period at the same time. And it was like the worst. I was literally, yeah, it was bad. Okay, anyway, this one's titled Apple Juice.
Ooh.
I fear this might be another situation. Okay. I was in first grade. My teacher got so annoyed at the girls grouping together for bathroom breaks. She said no one else could go until recess. Well, I legitimately had to go and started peeing in my seat. I tried to keep it in so you could only hear dribbling, but then the floodgates opened. When my... Man, you must have really had to go. Like, see, fucking school.
Yeah.
When my desk buddy noticed, we both jumped up from the desk and I acted dumbfounded. Hold on, kid. Since we had the class's attention, I said, someone put apple juice in my desk. Most students actually believed me and started cleaning up with paper towels.
You gotta That's smart.
And apple juice? Like, it does kind of look like apple
it
juice.
It does look like apple juice. Smart.
My teacher knew what happened, had to call my mom, and she took me out to the hallway and sincerely apologized. Good. Well, as she should.
As she should. But yeah, that's, again, just...
And to call your mom, because, like, I don't know, like, when I was in school and I had the period accident, like, they didn't let me call my mom. They just, like, made me go to class. Like, yeah. That she did the right thing. I'm glad that happened. To this day, I'm not upset with her teacher. I could tell she put enough blame and punishment on herself, and she had explained to my mother enough said.
Yeah.
Good.
Ooh. Even worse. Having to explain anything to my mom?
Ooh, yeah, your mom's Gina. Scary.
Not Gina. My mom would have fucking owned the school. Like, she would have gone to the ends of the earth. Don't play with Gina.
I love that she was quick on her feet. Like, oh my god, how'd your apple juice get here? Like, where's the box?
Yeah.
Where's the apple juice box?
I, very smart. I wouldn't have thought about that. I don't know what I would have said in that moment. I know. Like, fuck. Hey, girls. What a vibe you two are. Two amazing humans who inspired the shit out of me.
Aw. Thank you.
My story is an embarrassing wake-up call. So, since you both are former retail girls, as well as I thought I would make I might wait. So, since both are former retail girls as well, I thought you might like this one. Now, we all know, us retail people, that sometimes we get the most annoying clients that are just so indecisive and it makes you want to pull your hair out. I worked at a pet shop at the time. I had a couple contact us while wanting me to put some products aside for them. They made me make up about 4 different boxes before they decided on a final one. They would ask questions that I had already answered about 2 times before. The problem is it's involving animals. I get so mad when people have pets and don't know the basics, just very, very annoying, and they were coming to pick it up themselves. I'm busy making the package, and one of my colleagues asked me about it, and I just went off telling her all about how absolutely dumb these people were and how I cannot believe how people who know so little have animals in the first place. Just really getting angry all over again. Little did I know the couple had to come pick up their box stuff and had been standing behind me this whole time.
Ooh, that's so uncomfortable.
They were very sweet about it, which made me feel even worse. Now, I know this might not seem that bad, but I swear to you, I have never before or since felt that kind of embarrassment and shame. I learned a lot about myself and customer service in this encounter. I was still new in the service industry and needed to learn. You can disagree with people, but that does not give you the right to judge them. I needed to learn that, so I took it as an embarrassing wake-up call. I feel you on that because I had a little instance in the beginning of my retail career where I was trying to, like, I was brand new to the job and I just wanted to fit in with the girls. I was 19 years old and I was not being taught by the most professional service people, my colleagues at the time. And so anytime like a client or customer would come up to us, they would always like roll their eyes, look at us, be like, kill, like mouth, like kill me, whatever. And so I was mimicking that because I felt like that's what I was supposed to do to like fit yeah. in. And I remember I did that one time and the manager caught me and he pulled me to the side and was like, what are you doing? And don't ever do that again. And that was really embarrassing for me. Thank God that wasn't a client. However, one of my colleagues after that, because I had learned my lesson, I was like, thank God that wasn't a client. And then I just got ripped up by my manager. Whatever. It is what it is. So we had a girl, a manager actually. She was a manager at the time and she was new to our location. She had already worked for Sephora, but she was new to the location. And it was a really, really busy weekend. And a client had like asked, we had like little gondolas and we were by the mascara gondola right in front of the entrance. And I don't know if this client was being like, to be honest, I don't even think the client was being too much. I think she just like asked about something and like this manager at the time just had that type of attitude when like people would just bother her, I guess.
She's a little fiery.
And she looks at the client and was like, yeah, maybe the client asked like, where's the mascaras or something like that.
It was like right there.
And it was right there. And she turned around and was like, right here. And then turns back to me and was like, God, people are so fucking stupid. Or said something like that. Woo, that client was right behind her. And she turned around, she goes, excuse me, are you talking about me? And she goes, no. And like my manager turns around and was like, no, why would I ever be talking about you? And she goes, I don't know. They ended up like getting into it. The client was fucking right. And I was so embarrassed for her. They ended up like resolving it and was like, I wasn't talking to you, blah, blah, blah. And the client was like, yes, you were. And like, you're unprofessional and blah, blah, blah. Yeah. And ended up like being a whole thing. And so again, just to like piggyback off the customer service, you just don't fucking act like that.
Yeah, you know what I mean? You have to like, put on like your customer service, like mask when you're at work.
Yes. Yeah. And there has been so many times where I've looked at a client and I'm like, I just want to fucking tell you
yeah.
how it is. But you can't. And so it is very humbling when you're in those situations where you're like, okay, no matter, like you said, you disagree with them.
Yeah.
You just have to bite your tongue and like save it for the car ride home to like call a friend or whoever just to vent because I get it.
Yeah.
But yeah.
I think one of my more embarrassing, well, it's not like, I don't know. I just feel like I don't really care anymore.
Yeah. You know? I'm not really embarrassed about things anymore.
But when I worked at Sephora and I was doing YouTube at the time, so like 10 years ago, someone commented on my YouTube and they said, my sister got her makeup done by you and said your breath stinks.
No, you never told me about that.
It stuck with me to this day.
What a comment. Like, that's not like after that, I would have been like, I'm brushing my teeth 7 times a day, making right? sure I get my water in. I have mints on me at all times. Right? That is why I don't breathe on my clients because, like, there's times it's where I like, so I don't hard. Know if my breath stinks or like, there's my, I don't breathe in people anymore. I mm-hmm. just keep my distance.
Yep.
Oh my
yep.
God.
So that stuck with me.
That is fucking hilarious. You've never told me that.
Holy shit.
Because I was embarrassed. Because my breath stinks. So good. These are funny. I love that they were all mostly about shit, though.
Yeah, I guess we all shit our pants.
But, you know, it's funny because, like, nobody else, to me, there's, like, no other level of embarrassment then. Because people are like, fuck, no, nothing else embarrasses me except for when I shit my pants.
Why am I not embarrassed about shitting my pants?
You know, I maybe for me it's not necessarily...
Like, I think if I shat my pants in public, mm-hmm. I feel like I could cover it up.
Yeah.
Like, I feel like it wouldn't be obvious. But if I got my period in public, I feel like it would be obvious. But even that, I don't think I would be embarrassed. I feel like people understand. And I'd be like, oops, gotta go
yeah,
fix it.
Mine would just be more pissed off that I don't have something to remedy it mm-hmm. if I'm out.
Yeah, I'd be more upset at my clothes.
Right.
Like right you. Now, I'm like really questioning my cushion.
But, like, if you were to get up and I'd be like, oh, yeah, you got blood all over that. Yeah, it's not embarrassing.
Like, damn it.
I know. Yeah, but like, things that are out of your control, they're just not embarrassing to me. So that could be farting, shitting, pissing, anything that just, like, you physically cannot control. And, like, that's normal. It's normal. Mm-hmm. Maybe it's not normal to shit your pants and, like, have a shit stain walking down the, you know, I can see that being embarrassing, but the act of it is normal. So
yeah.
I get it.
Yeah. Do you have any other embarrassing stories?
I feel like I've mentioned this before. No, I definitely have mentioned this before, but I can mention it again. Well, it wasn't one night. It was my best friend's wedding, and we drank way too much, like blacked out, like blackout city. I was drinking White Claws and taking shots of Jameson. Like, don't ever mix those two together unless you want a blackout. Anyway, went to bed, woke up the next day, and everybody had a story for me. And I said, what do you mean? I was fast asleep all night long. I slept great. No, apparently I woke up in the middle of the night. Again, I'm blacked out. And we were all sharing a room together. So there was three couples in this bedroom, and I had to go to the bathroom. And I walked over to the one bed where my best friend Drea was sleeping, and I pulled my pants and go to hover and piss on her. Now, that would have been embarrassing, I guess, if I did pee on her. I didn't. Jake actually stopped it before I did. But even if I did pee on her, I would have still loved it. It would have been funny and would have sucked for her. And I wouldn't have been embarrassed.
That's so funny.
But other people might think that's embarrassing.
I love the hover. It's the, I'm going to get over my pants off.
Yeah, yeah. I thought it was a toilet, apparently.
She wakes up to your snatch.
She did. She woke up. She was like, Amanda, what? Again, I was blacked out.
I heard
this from them the next day. But Jake said, I got out of bed, hovered over her, took my pants down. And he said, what are you doing? And I said, going to the bathroom. And because I responded going to the bathroom, it woke her up, and she was like, what are you doing? And I was like, going to the bathroom, like, just like pissed off at everybody, apparently.
I'm pissing on you.
And Jake was like, no, you're not in the bathroom, you're over Andrea. And I was like, ugh. And I stormed off to another bathroom that was in the house and sat on the toilet.
An actual bathroom
and sat on the toilet for like 45 minutes. He had to come get me. But I know none of that. Like,
that's so funny.
None of that's in my memory. So I couldn't have really been embarrassed because I was blacked out.
Yeah.
But that would have been a great story to tell if I actually did pee on her.
My favorite for me, like my funniest embarrassing story, I think, is just when I opened up the door. When the DoorDash guy was taking a picture of it, and he asked if he should send me the picture, and it's me like opening the door,
like couldn't get it fast enough.
Yeah. Like, give me my slop.
Could you imagine, like, you open the door and your little hand was creeped out just to snatch it as fast as you can? He's like,
and he was like, oh, sorry. Do you want it?
Cool. Yeah, no, so I probably have so many other embarrassing stories. I'm just blanking on them right now because, again, I just don't find them embarrassing. They're just moments in time. I feel like when you're a kid and, like, you randomly go up to somebody and you're like, dad, and it's not your dad at the grocery store, like, those are, you know, trivial embarrassing stories. I've done that. I've definitely went up to the wrong person, said dad, and it wasn't my dad.
One time Ruben was at work. He worked at, like, an audio place, and someone had, like, a funny head, like, something was funny about this person, and Ruben took a picture and it went
no, so the person knows that he took the photo.
Like, I turned around and Ruben's like, Ruben said, just take a picture of my shoes.
Holy shit.
It's applesauce.
That's hilarious. Like, being caught, stuff like that, we're like, fuck. That's funny.
At least make sure you're silent as yeah.
My head would whip around so fast. What the fuck? You taking a picture?
Delete it.
Delete. You see that TikTok sound where it was like,
delete it.
Delete it.
It's from A Simple Favor. Have you seen that movie?
Seen that. You
should watch it. It's good.
I love it though.
Well, those are the embarrassing stories.
Love them. I guess we're all on the same page on what's embarrassing.
Everyone shit their pants.
Love that for us.
That's all. Thanks for listening.
Things are coming here.
Thanks for shitting your pants.
Thank you so much for shitting your pants and sharing it with us.
I'm shitting my pants over right now.
I'm shitting my pants right now.
If you'd like to watch this episode, head over to our YouTube channel at In Her Skin Podcast.
Join the community by following us on Instagram at In Her Skin Podcast and TikTok at In Her Skin.
If you love what you heard, please leave a rating and review. It'll help to support the show. Thanks for listening.